الحمد لله الذي أمدى الأفلاك والأرضين والصلاة والسلام على من كان نبيا وآدم بين الماء والطين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم صدق الله العظيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Respected scholars, Allama Imam Khalid, Allama Imam Adil Shahzad, respected Naat Khan, my brothers, listeners, Assalamu Alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm just going to be quite short because the time does not permit us to give a lengthy lecture. Imam Khalid has mentioned already about the beauty of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Ghaliban Imam Hafiz Sharif mentioned about the akhlaq and the adab and the character of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And after their lecture, I don't think I need to speak anymore. In ashar ke saath कि जमाले मुसहफ़े कुरान को रूबरू रखो, जमाले मुसहफ़े कुरान को रूबरू रखो, हदीस आयत रहमत को हूबहू रखो, हदीस आय रहमत को हूबहू रखो, बयान मदह रसूल अनाम से पहले, बयान मदह रसूल अनाम से पहले तुम अपने सारे ख्यालों को बावजू रखो, तुम अपने सारे ख्यालों को बावजू रखो। माई रिस्पेक्टेड यंगस्टर्स, वी लिव इन द 21st सेंचुरी एंड व्हाट इज आवर एम एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव? सक्सेस। I want success. A doctor, success. A teacher, success. Imam of the masjid, success. An orator, success. Mechanic, success. But according to the Sufia, the Sufis, they say before you attain success, ask, what is success? I was in Leicester and we got a phone call. Hussaini Miah said, Ji, dua kariye. Maine kaha, kis liye? Pakistan is playing. Acha. Against West Indies. Acha. And dua for what? So Pakistan wins the match. Winning the match is success? Winning a match is success? Ask Sayyidina Junaid Baghdadi. He will say losing a match is success. For he lost against a descendant of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Success, what is success? A brother might stand up. MasterCard, Visa card, wealth in the bank, comfort of this world, having children, having authority and leadership. This is success. Wealth and children is success. The land of Karbala will tell you, sacrificing your wealth and children is success. What is success? As soon as you said that, the Muazzin said, Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala salah, hayya ala al-falah, hayya ala al-falah, hurry towards salah,
come towards salah, hurry towards success. Yes, reading salah, reading namaz is success. But Maula Ali will tell you, sometime postponing salat is successful. What is success? We will ask Sayyidina Junaid Baghdadi. What is success? We will ask Imam Hussain. What is success? We will ask Maula Ali. They will say, Imam Hazrat Junaid Baghdadi will say, I lost that match. For who? For Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Imam Hussain will say, I sacrificed my family, my children, my wealth and health for Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Maula Ali would say, I sacrificed my asr for the love of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Success is not in wealth. Success is not in authority. Success is not in wealth and comfort. Success is at the feet of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. This is success. You want success? The Sufis say, beautiful thing. You want success? Going to the moon is not success. Kissing the feet of he who split the moon into two is success. Come towards Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. In his remembrance is your success. In his company is your success. In his adherence is your success. In his adab and in his love is your success. Do you want to gain success? We talked about the asr of Mawla Ali. A beautiful topic. We can talk about days and nights, and this is the favorite topic of the Sufis. They say Hazrat Mawla Ali had two options. The Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was resting. Hazrat Mawla Ali could have told, Ya Rasulullah, please get up. I need to pray Asr. He had two options. Asr is an act of worship. But the adab of Rasul is also an act of worship. Loving the Prophet is also ibadat. Asr is also ibadat. Loving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is also an act of worship. Is there any scholar here present superior in knowledge than Mawla Ali? Any mufti? Any muhaddis? Any faqih? Any mutakallim? Any mujtahid? In the UK, anyone? In Saudi Arabia, anyone? What was the decision of Mawla Ali? What was the faisla? Hazrat Mawla Ali ka faisla kya tha? Ek taraf asr, ek taraf muhabbat rasool. Ek rasta asr ka hai. Ek rasta muhabbat rasool. Ek rasta asr, khuda ki ibadat. Dusra muhabbat rasool. Ab Mawla Ali to babul ilm hai. Mawla Ali wo hai ki jinke paas huzur sallallahu taala alaihi wasallam se jinke paas ilm hasil hua. To Mawla Ali se bada koi mufti hai? Mawla Ali se bada alim koi hai? Mawla Ali karte kya hai? Mawla Ali karte kya hai? Mawla Ali ne ye dekha, you know, the Sufi said Mawla Ali, he looked an act of worship. This is also an act of worship. Loving the Prophet is also an act of worship. When two acts of worship came together at one time, he performed that which was more superior. He performed that. Why? Because through the love of Muhammad Rasulullah will ever be my salah accepted in the courtyard of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mawla Ali ne kya dekha? Ye daleel hai. He is the evidence of the existence of Allah. He is the evidence. He is Burhan. He is Burhan-e-Azim, the greatest evidence of the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Haan, Sufiya farmate hain, fark tha. Agar Mawla Ali asr ki namaz ke liye khade hote, to chehra Kaabe ki taraf hota. Lekin jab chehra Mustafa ki taraf tha, to ye Kaabe ke qible ki taraf tha. My respected friends, success. You want success? Go to Madinatul Munawwara. Laqad manna Allahu 'alal mu'minina izba'atha fihim rasulan min anfusihim. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored upon the believers. What is the favor? By sending a prophet, a great azim prophet amongst them. a Rasul.
Why is he a favor? Have you ever realized that? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam as his greatest favor?
Why? What was the purpose of your creation and my creation? Why were we created? To?
وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ.
The purpose of our creation is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must believe in Him. To believe in Him, we must know Him. Yes? The purpose of our creation is to worship Allah. To worship Allah, you must believe in Him. To believe in Him, you must know Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you 5 sources of knowledge. He gave you eyesight so you can see and gain knowledge. He gave you tongue, the power of taste, the power of hearing, the power of seeing, the power of smelling, the power of your brain. But the point is, can you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can you feel Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can you hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can you imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And if you don't know Him, you will not be able to believe in Him. And if you do not believe in Him, you will not be able to worship Him. And if you don't worship Him, your destination is hellfire. And your 5 sources of knowledge, Allah is beyond that. Your brain cannot imagine Him. Your eyes cannot see Him. One being was required. One link was required. One link was required. Who was Bashar and Nur? Who was Bashar and Nur? Who was the greatest evidence of the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? One personality was required. Wallahi al-azim, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the greatest favor upon the believers is Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Through Him, you recognize Me. Through Him, you recognize Me. Through Him, you believed in Him. And following Him, you know the acts of worship. Greatest favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why, my friends, we were talking and he mentioned about the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Imam Khalid mentioned about that He's present. He's with us. He's with us. Why? Because the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you do a favor upon someone, I gave you a gift, I did a favor upon you. You gave me iPad 5 or 4, whatever it is, you did a favor upon me. Right? You gave me some money, you did a favor upon me. I gave you some money, I did a favor upon you. But if I take that money away, what will you say? Hussaini Miah did a favor upon me. Does the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala applies till now? And until the day of judgment? Yes, Allah did favor upon every believer until the day of judgment. If the favor applies until the day of judgment, the ni'mat must also exist. The ni'mat must also exist. This is why if you read Kitab al-Shifa and Sharah of Kitab al-Shifa, it's mentioned when you go into an empty house, say, and there's no one to say salam, say assalamu alayka ayyuhan nabi wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Why? Read Sharah al-Shifa. Scholars write, why? Because the soul of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is present in the houses of every Muslim. He's present. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is present. My respected friends, you want success? Come at the feet of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We talked about the Shama'il, the beauty, the perfection of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How perfect he was. How beautiful he was. A unique, a perfect personality. Whether it's his character, whether it is his physicality, his beauty, his manifestation. In every angle, he was a perfect human being. He was a perfect personality. And we read from the from the life of the Sahaba and from the narration of Ma'bad. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was traveling with his companions, he went at a place because they were hungry, they were thirsty, and Ma'bad was there. I'm not going to describe this incident. It's a very, very famous qissa story. And so she had a goat. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked for milk. There's no milk. She said the goat is weak, she cannot give milk. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam placed his blessed hands upon the goat. And not containers upon containers upon containers were filled. These were not ordinary hands. These were not ordinary hands. When these hands throw, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا رَمَيْتَ إِذْ رَمَيْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ رَمَى. These are not normal and ordinary hands. When he throws, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he does not throw, I throw. I throw. These are not ordinary hands. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُبَايِعُونَكَ إِنَّمَا يُبَايِعُونَ اللَّهَ يَدُ اللَّهِ فَوْقَ أَيْدِيهِمْ. When, Ya Rasulullah, you do bait, you take bait of these believers, you're not taking bait, I am taking bait. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am taking bait. يَدُ اللَّهِ, it's the hand of Allah upon their hands. These are not ordinary hands. These are not ordinary hands. This is why we say the hands of our mashayikh are not ordinary hands. Why? Because they hold the hands of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is why the hands of Data Ganjbaksh Ali Hajveri and Khwaja Mainuddin Chishti and Ghousia Azam Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani are not the hands of ordinary individuals. They hold the hands of Maul Ali, and Maul Ali holds the hands of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These hands, and when these blessed hands were placed upon the goat, milk upon milk. And then when they left, Ma'bad, she was amazed at this beauty of Muhammad Rasulullah. Her husband came and she described the beauty. Ra'itu rajulan. Zahir al-wada'a. Ablaj al-wajh. Hasan al-khalq. I saw a man, extremely beautiful. Light, as if light and brightness was manifesting from his body. How beautiful he was. Extremely handsome. Beautiful face. As they say, Nurani Chehra jise kehte hain. Nurani Chehra. My respected friends, his face. You know, people say, don't judge a book by its cover. Don't judge a man by his apparent nature and his fitrah. Don't judge a man. But Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, this rule finishes where he starts. This rule, this is why Abdullah ibn Salam, when he saw the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam for the first time, he was not a Muslim. He saw the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he saw his face, he looked at his face, he saw the beauty of the face of Muhammad Rasulullah. He asked him no question, no arguments, no cross-examination. He saw his face and he says, Araftu anna wajahu laysa biwajhi kazab. When I saw the face, the beautiful face of Muhammad Rasulullah, I knew that this face cannot be a face of a liar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. So I accept Islam and I accept you as the messenger of Allah. The beautiful face of Muhammad. You know, this hadith, this description of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by Ma'bad is a very long description. My final point. She said a beautiful thing. She said, Ajmalun nas abhahum min ba'id. Allah. Wa ahlahu wa ahsanuhu min qareeb. And he was the most beautiful person from far. You know, when you look at someone from far, you think, mashallah, nice person. When he comes near you, you think, hey, who's this Jack the lad? But she said a beautiful thing. She said, he was so beautiful from Ba'id, the best of people from Ba'id. But when he came near, he was even more beautiful. He was even more beautiful. Whether you see him from near, whether you see him from Ba'id, he was beautiful. And not just, it does not apply by distance, but if you understand this statement by not just distance, but by time, Allah. By time, those who saw him, they described his beauty. Hassan bin Ibn Sabit, Main madahtu Muhammadan bi maqalati, walakin madahtu maqalati bi Muhammadin. I cannot praise the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with my naat. My naat, my poetry becomes praiseworthy because of the name of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said that because he was close to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. 1,000 years after, Peer Meher Ali Shah said, "Kithe Meher Ali, kithe teri sana, gustakh kiya kithe ja ladiya." Remember those who saw him from near. From closeness, they saw the beauty of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hazrat Abu Ayyub al Ansari was sitting at the grave of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Marwan said, "Hey, what are you doing? What are you sitting next to a stone?" He says, "I'm not sitting next to a stone. I'm sitting next to Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam." This is the statement of he who was close, who was qareeb with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine and observe the statement of he who came 1,000 years later but saw the beauty of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, "Tu zinda hai wallah, tu zinda hai wallah, meri chashme alam se chup jane wale." This is the beauty of Ma. Even if you see him from far, 1400 years before, they described his beauty. 1400 years after, we are still describing his beauty. From far, he was beautiful. From near, he's beautiful. 1400 years before, Khalid bin Walid and his companions and his followers would say in battle, "Ya Muhammadah, Ya Muhammadah, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah." 1400 years after, in this masjid in London, you all are saying, "Ya Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah." From far he was beautiful, from near he was beautiful. This is the maqam of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Summarizing this entire event, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to follow Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to love him, to follow him, and to follow his sahaba and his family. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.